Just a year after its launch, Palo Alto-based K-Scale Labs is already ruffling feathers in the robotics world. Founder Benjamin Bolte, an engineer who's worked on robotics for Tesla and Meta, came out swinging like 50 Cent in early 2025, causing tension in Silicon Valley with public shots at unicorn rivals. He insists that making robots open and affordable is the only way to get billions of them into the real world. When he criticized Figure's approach to doing everything in-house and questioned its transparency, founder Brett Adcock called him an idiot.
I personally am very excited about the world's best humanoid robot being open source and shared by everyone, and built for developers by developers, not some other companies.
K-Scale's name is a likely reference to the Kardashev Scale, a highly influential concept in astrophysics that measures a civilization's technological advancement based on energy consumption. Soviet astrophysicist Nikolai Kardashev introduced the framework in 1964, categorizing civilizations as follows. A Type 1 civilization harnesses all the energy available on its planet, including renewable sources like solar, wind, and geothermal, and can control natural processes like weather and volcanoes. A Type 2 civilization captures the full amount of energy output of its star, possibly using structures like Dyson spheres. A Type 3 civilization harnesses the energy of an entire galaxy, manipulating stars and black holes. Type 4 and 5 civilizations are speculative, with godlike abilities like countering universe-scale events and multiverse energy control. Carl Sagan placed Earth's civilization at 0.7 in 1973 when he proposed a refined version of the scale based on real-world energy use. The Kardashev scale became popular among science fiction fans and futurists in the 70s and 80s, and today it's frequently cited in discussions about AI advancements. K-Scale cites it heavily in its messaging.
We're building the infrastructure to make humanity into a Type 1 Kardashev civilization, and we're making it open source and available for everyone.
Bolt founded K-Scale Labs in 2024 after leaving Meta, where he worked on the AI research team teaching robots and computer systems to learn from the world around them. He previously worked at Tesla as a senior autopilot engineer, writing the CUDA code behind a 3D vision system called the voxel occupancy network. The system served as the first perception model for Tesla's Optimus humanoid robot. The team secured $500,000 in seed funding after the startup incubator, Y Combinator, added it to its winter 2024 batch. K-Scale has secured additional funding, but its war chest is small compared to other US startups racing to deploy their humanoids at scale like Figure, 1X Technologies, and Agility Robotics. K-Scale introduced its early humanoid robot prototype named Stompy in February 2024. Standing about 122 centimeters, or 4 feet, the robot was built with materials costing under $10,000. Its CAD model is shown here loaded into NVIDIA's Isaac Sim platform. The robot's digital twin learns in a simulated environment on its own through trial and error. The learned behaviors are then transferred to the physical hardware via a process called Sim2Real, short for simulation to reality. The technique has become standard among the perceived leaders in the humanoid robotics race. It's been credited with quickly enabling human-like walking, dancing, and martial arts moves.
What this is a bunch of robots running in simulation in parallel, taking actions and learning how to maximize reward using reinforcement learning.
K-Scale has open-sourced its simulation to reality pipeline as it takes pre-orders for two budget humanoid robots. Zeroth Bot, or Z-Bot, is priced just under $1,000. Standing about 46 centimeters, or a foot and a half, Z-Bot is geared towards students and developers. Z-Bot's pricing is notable for undercutting short humanoids from Chinese firms like Unitree Robotics and Engine. Short humanoids like Unitree's G1 Engines PM1, Agibot's Linkshi X2, and the T1 by Booster Robotics are growing in popularity among researchers and developers as China aims to deploy robotic humanoids at scale in 2025 and lead the industry by 2027. While ZBot isn't as sturdy as high-performing models from Unitree and Engine, it fills a gap in the United States by offering a relatively affordable, developer-friendly humanoid platform. Researchers from UC Berkeley have a similar goal with their new lightweight humanoid robot that can be built with 3D printed parts for under $5,000. K-Scale's higher-end model is called the K-Bot. Standing 1.4 meters, or about 4 feet 7 inches, the robot is priced just under $9,000 for developers, researchers, and hobbyists who want to build and test real-world AI and robotics. The humanoid robot possesses actuators that deliver 120 newton meters of torque and supports swappable attachments for different tasks. The K-Bot could be seen as the West's answer to China's open-source general-purpose humanoid robot, Tiangong, developed by the government-backed Beijing innovation hub, X-Humanoid. Tiangong has been upgraded considerably since its 2024 introduction and recently made headlines for its first-place finish in the first-ever humanoid robot half-marathon. Choices are much more limited for researchers and developers interested in full-sized humanoid robots at this point. One of the most popular options is Unitree's H1, which is available starting around $90,000. Other full-sized humanoids are beginning to hit the market that are priced around $30,000 from Chinese firms like UB Tech. And US-based upstarts like Westwood Robotics have recently introduced new research platforms. K-Scale is also developing a model called M-Bot that's about 70 centimeters tall and priced under $3,000 for early buyers. Another robotics firm known for its open-source approach recently got acquired by one of the most influential companies in artificial intelligence. With a former Tesla Optimus engineer at the helm, they're racing toward a future where anyone can build a humanoid robot just like this without leaving home. The modular robot is priced around $70,000 and is already in use at top institutions like Cornell University and Carnegie. For more on that, check the related video.